This is a video showing the rate of force development within PASCO Capstone. I've previously captured a run of data from using our force platform that shows the force versus time. I'm going to resize this so that there's room for other displays. The maximum normal force that's generated by the athlete can be displayed either on the main graph or on a separate digits display. We'll do that now by clicking the digits and dragging it over to one of the blue boxes. From select measurement, we'll go down to normal force. This normal force that's displayed right here is the last value if the run is stopped, or the current value if data is still being collected. Instead, we want to use our statistics tool to display the maximum value that's developed. So we'll do that by clicking on the right arrow and changing from mean to maximum. Once we've done that, you can see that the display has not changed. The statistics button is actually split, and we actually need to press the sigma so that it will display the maximum value, and that's shown in the middle of that display. So we can also do individual analysis of the different peaks on our force versus time graph. We'll do that by concentrating on the left-hand side and selecting our highlighter tool. Our highlighter tool can be used, can be resized, and then placed over portions of the graph. And then we can actually apply the statistics for just that area. Again, we'll select just the maximum this time. Within the graph, you can actually select multiple statistics to be displayed. But again, we have to click on the sigma so that it will actually display the value. Here it's truncated at the top, simply resizing a little bit to show the maximum value for that top peak, and that matches our digits display. We can also move the selected area to highlight other areas of the exercise to see the maximum forces that are developed in those regions as well. Now, the rates of force development, the slopes of these areas, can also be very important. So let me show the creation of those calculations. So in order to display that, we'll first create another area, another axis to display these on. This is locked in time with the above graph so that they will be synced in time. We'll click on the calculator. We can see the calculator here. We'll click on that top line to activate that line. And then we will create a name for rate of force development. Down below in the calculator section, we're going to now select the special button. And then from those options, we'll select the derivative. Once we've selected the derivative, it will give us the arguments for that function. Because the derivative function can be noisy, we're going to change that first argument from 2 to 5. That means that it will take the derivative over 5 points rather than 2 points, and will reduce some of the noise. In the second argument, we'll right-click the mouse, and then from that, we'll go to Insert Data and select Normal Force. Once we've done that, then we need to select the proper units. In this case, it will be newtons per second. Once that's done, we can close down the calculator so that we have more of our area displayed. Since we've done the calculation, we now have that calculation under the Select Measurement option. And we'll go ahead and select that and put that on our graph. Right now we're down in the noise band of that, so what we're going to have to do is select, click and hold on the numbers on the vertical axis and push them toward the origin. And that will rescale it so that we have the actual meaningful peaks of the system visible. Once we've done that, then we can apply to it further analysis. So just as we did with the above calculation, we're going to apply the smoothing function. And you can see that the values are being reduced, but it's again showing more of the meaningful portions of the data. This will affect it later on in terms of the raw data won't actually reflect these values because the top peaks are actually being averaged over and being reduced. But again, it shows the areas of greatest force development. What else can be very helpful is to use the selection area to select the values that are at different portions. So if there is different rates of force development during different portions of the exercise, those can be determined. We also may be interested in displaying the global maximum values of these. So we'll do that by generating another digits display and placing it on the right-hand side. We'll go up to Select Measurement, and this time we'll go down to Select Rate of Force Development. Again, as before, this will display the last value of the collected data, but instead we're going to want to select the maximum. Again, this displays the last value. We'll need to click on the sigma to have it display the last value, and that shows the maximum of the original value.